Hi everyone, welcome back. Today in this video, I'm going to explain how to set up the Launch Scopebox. You guys might know that we have many videos on the channel that I explain how to read and analyze the waveform on multiple sensors or on the network as well. But many of you asked me on those videos to make a video and explain how to do the setup on oscilloscope when we are reading any waveform. Because of course, when you are reading a waveform, you need to perform some setting to be able to read the waveform properly. But today I'm gonna explain everything you need to do that setup on the Launch Scopebox. To find other videos for reading and analyzing the waveform, you can find the videos on this video description. And you can also find our online courses on udemy.com. You can find the link for those courses in this video description as well. Before starting the video, if you guys haven't subscribed to the channel, please don't forget to subscribe to get the notification when we upload new videos. Okay, let's just start. So first of all, let's have a look at the devices. This is Launch Scopebox, a four channel scope box. As you see, we have four channels in here. I'm using channel one today. Of course, you can use all four channels at the very same time. This scope box is connected to the scan tool. So the scan tool is gonna show the waveform to us. We can perform all the setting in here. This is actually the scope box interface. This one is connected to the scan tool with this cable. So in here, for finding the scope box, you need to go to the more toolbox and you see the scope box right here. Click on enter and you have the waveform. We are getting the waveform right now because I have connected the scope box probes right now on the LIN-Bus. This one is a quite good waveform to explain everything on it. I'm gonna explain how to connect the probes as well. Then we will get back here to explain everything on the scope box as well. This is one of the scope box probes. As you see, you have this end to be connected to the scope box. This one that I have already connected. You can use any channels that you want. And on the other end, you have this too. This red one should be connected on the signal of the sensor that you are trying to read the waveform from it. For example, if you are trying to read the waveform from the cam sensor, this one should be on the cam sensor signal, and this one should be on the ground. For example, for this case that I'm showing today right now, this is the ground, and this cable, as you see, is inserted to the LIN-Bus. On this car, alternator is controlled through the LIN-Bus. So I just disconnected the connector from the LIN-Bus and I back-propped it using one of those test props. Then I have inserted the scope box prop on the LIN-Bus. So I have these two connected right now. But if you are reading the waveform from any other sensors, for example, if you are reading the waveform from the cam sensor, you just need to find the signal wire on the cam sensor and insert the test prop from here, and then you can pick up the signal from here. But this is basically it. You find that wire that you are trying to read the waveform from it, you connect the red part of the probe on it and like one on a good ground. On this one, on the LIN-Bus, which is actually a low speed network, as soon as I turn the ignition switch on, I have the waveform. But of course, for some of them, like the cam sensor, crank sensor, you have to start the engine to be able to read the waveform. So right now that we have inserted the probes, we should be able to read the waveform as we are reading here. I'm gonna zoom in on the scope box right here, so it's gonna be much clearer for you guys. So this waveform that we are getting right now is really clear and really nicely shown, because this is actually on the last setting that I had on this scope box. But sometimes when you are reading the waveform is all over the place, so you need to do some adjustment. So for the adjustment, you should be able to understand all these items that you have on the side. First of all, you need to know that scope box is showing the voltage over the time. Okay, so this is basically how voltage changes over the time. So it means on this axis, on this side, we are reading the voltage, and here we can see the time. So that's what scope box is doing. It's showing the voltage over the time. So basically, for performing the adjustment, you can adjust, you can change this voltage setting and time setting. you have some pre-adjusted waveform right here, as you see, automotive. If I click on it, you have some items from here that you can select from. For example, circuits is showing you some cases like 12 volt charging, 24 volt charging that you can select from. It's really based on the item that you are trying to capture. On the sensors, if you click on the sensor, you have ABS sensor, accelerator pedal sensor, airflow meter sensor, camshaft, crankshaft sensor. All of them are listed here. You can select one of them and that's it. On the actuators, you have the glow plugs, you have the injectors, you have idle speed control valve. So you can select what you want. Ignition coils are listed in here, primary, secondary, or primary, secondary together. On the network, we have CAN bus, high and low. We have the LIN-Bus. This is exactly what we are getting today, flex ray and K-line. A combination is when you are trying to read the waveform from multiple components at the same time, like cam and crankshaft sensor, or crank sensor and primary ignition coil. So you can select from any of them and your scan tool is gonna set it up automatically. But generally, I really like to do everything manually because I wanna see what I'm doing. I'm gonna adjust it perfectly to something which is easier for myself to read and to analyze. So for adjusting the voltage, you can adjust it from here. For adjusting the time, you can adjust it from here. First of all, if you look at here, we have some divisions on the screen. So 10 divisions over here and 10 divisions over here. This vertical section is showing the voltage. This horizontal section is showing the time. And I have some voltage shown in here as 2 volts. As you see, channel one is showing 2 volts. So this 2 volt is representing the voltage per division. So it means each division right now on the screen equals to 2 volts. So 2 volts, 2 volts, 2 volts. Totally, I have 10 sections or 10 divisions. It means my scan tool is covering 20 volts right now. And on the time setting, I have 5 milliseconds. It means each division right now equals to 5 milliseconds. So it means right now my scan tool is covering 50 milliseconds totally. By changing this, you can actually adjust the waveform. For example, if you want to have a taller waveform or shorter waveform, you just need to change the voltage. You can just tap on this one. As you see, it's showing you a taller waveform. If I tap on it, you see voltage is 1 volt. It means each division right now on the screen equals to 1 volt. So that's why waveform is taller. But this is not a really good setting for me because I don't see the waveform properly. If I tap on this one, I see a shorter waveform. This one is quite good, but I can show you a shorter one as well. So right now, each division on the voltage axis equals to 5 volts. It's giving me a quite small waveform, but this is good if you are getting multiple waveforms at the same time on the screen. But right now that I have only one channel, I can just go for this, which is quite good. And for the time setting, you can just click on the time and you can select any time setting that you want, or you can adjust it from these two. If you tap on this one, it means you see less number of waveform. This one is gonna show you more number of waveform. As you see here, we have 5 milliseconds. If I click on this, we have 10 milliseconds. It means more number of waveforms. If I tap on this one, I will see less number of waveform and again less. So right now I have 2 milliseconds per division and totally my scan tool is covering 20 milliseconds. But this one, as I said, is a proper setting for reading this waveform. This is for time and voltage setting. You can turn on and off the channels from here. For example, if I wanna turn on the channel 2, I tap on it. As you see, I have channel 2 right now. You see the color code, yellow is for channel 1. This bluish color is for channel 2. I don't get any signal right now, of course, because the probe is not connected. For channel 3, it's this color. It's already there, and channel 4. So all of them are shown on the screen right now. This green is channel 4. But if I want to turn it off, just like this. So all channels are gone. I have only channel 1. But generally, if you wanna, for example, if you have channel 2, you can select the channels from here as well. If you have multiple channels and you want to select them, for example, right now I have two channels. As you see, they are overlapping. One channel is on the other channel. I want to make them separate. You can select the channels from here. It's on channel one. So right now, if I put my finger on the screen and move it up and down, I'm going to actually move the waveform on channel one. And if I change this one to channel two, and right now, if I put my finger on the screen and move it down, I'm going to move the channel two down. Or you can do something else. On this side of the screen, you see this number two and one. They are actually for channel one and channel two. If I tap on channel one, you see channel one. Right now, channel one is going to move. If I tap on channel two is going to move. So I don't need channel two right now. Let's turn it off and channel one a little up. So right now that we did the adjustment, in here you have some other adjustment as well. Basically, if you're on DC measurement, and basically if the probe that you are using is for voltage or current measurement, you have some items here as well. And this is basically for the time that you are reading the waveform, for example, from ignition coil or injectors, that the voltage level is gonna go really high. And for protecting your scope box, you have to use attenuator. So this attenuator is gonna drop the voltage. This one is a 20:1 attenuator. It means this one is gonna reduce the voltage that we are delivering to the scope box 20 times. But because the voltage is dropped 20 times, if you don't have proper adjustment in here, your reading will be inaccurate. So that's why if you are using this one, 20:1 attenuator, you need to click on this 20X. Or sometimes you have 10X attenuator, you just click on 10. But right now that we are not using it, we just leave it on one. So this one goes actually between the scope box probe and scope box itself. It should be connected just like this. Scope box is here and the probe is just right there. When we are getting the waveform, anytime that we want to stop the waveform, you can click on this. Waveform is going to freeze, so you can start reading whatever you want to read. You have some items here for saving the waveform. If you go for save sample, you're going to save it with just a name. You can just enter a name here, for example, Lin, and save. So this is already saved. And if you click on the quick save, you will have two options. This one is actually for recording a video from the screen, and this one is actually for saving the waveform. For example, if I go for this one, as you see, I have the screen recorded. So already started and saved with this name. Over here, I have the cursors, because as I said, we have the voltage and time in here. So we have two cursors. So this horizontal cursor is for checking the voltage. This vertical one is for checking the time. For example, if I click on this one, as you see, I have two lines, this one Y1 and Y2 down here. So on each one of them, there's a diamond. For example, on this one, if I click on the diamond, I'm gonna select it. So you can move this one up and down. If I put it right here, I'm gonna read the voltage right here, which is the maximum voltage. And for the minimum voltage, I need to tap on this Y2 and I need to move it to here. For example, right now, if you see that this line is not matching exactly with what you want, you can move it up and down by these two. And right now you have the Y1 and Y2 voltage, and the delta is shown at the top. So Y1 is showing the maximum voltage, which is 11.84. Y2 right here is showing the minimum voltage, which is 880 millivolts. And of course, this is the vertical cursor that you can check the time between X1 and X2. Another important point on the oscilloscope is the trigger, because using the trigger, you decide which part of the waveform should be shown where. So for example, if you go for the trigger, you have options for different channels, channel 1, 2, 3, 4. You can adjust different triggers for different channels. Here you can go for rising or falling edge. For example, if we go for falling edge right here, which is shown right here as well, you can adjust the trigger level from here. For example, what you see right now on the screen is shown the trigger. This one is the sign for the falling edge, and 2.88. It means anytime voltage falls below 2.88, trigger restarts. So here the trigger, you see, you can move the trigger to the left or to the right. And you can adjust the trigger level from here. You see, I'm adjusting the trigger level here. So I already adjusted it to 9.28. You can adjust it to anything you want. But basically, you need to adjust this one for that specific waveform that you have. For example, you have a waveform that on one point, voltage drops from 12 to 0. So you can actually set that point for the trigger. Anytime that the voltage drops from 12 to 0, trigger detects that one, and it's going to show it exactly at this point that you selected the trigger. So right now on this one, I have many waveforms meeting that requirement. So as you see right here, at this point, 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 at all of them, voltage drops to 9.12 right now, which I adjusted after going back to the base voltage, is gonna drop again. So it means trigger is meeting the requirement over and over and over and over again. But right now the waveform is quite good because the time setting is perfect. But sometimes when you are reading the waveform, for example, from the crankshaft position sensor, you can adjust this trigger exactly on that missing two section, exactly where we have the top dead center, where voltage spikes a little, you can adjust the trigger exactly on that point, and you have the top dead center point exactly on your trigger section. So, which is really important for reading the waveform. You can zoom on the waveform from here as well. As you see, when I zoom it, I have this section of the waveform. Okay, I can stop it. And I can move this one on any side of the waveform to read it properly. As you see, I have a better view right now, and I can navigate it on the waveform from here. There's not much else. So basically, the only thing you need is to connect the props properly to find the signal or the network or whatever you wanna read the waveform from it. You find the pin and wire on that component, connect the props, provide the ground, and here you need to provide proper setting. You can find the setting from here, or you can do it manually based on what I explained by adjusting the voltage or time setting. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you watched the other videos that we have on the channel for using the oscilloscope for diagnosing other components and other system and network, of course you will learn more. This video was specifically to show you how to set up the scope box, but those videos are gonna help you to use it more practically. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to visit the channel page for more diagnostic videos.